So Bapu, so this year, what kind of things we have for our audience today? Yeah.
Like a 4 or 5 years. And we have introduced extra day. It's like day-long workshops because we have taken feedback from you that most of you asked for a day-long workshop. So what are you guys looking forward to? I would like to take feedback from you and then see what we can make it better, how we can make it better. So anything from you?
Hi, I'm Priyanka. So I was yesterday attending half-day workshops, but that could be I think more time we can get in because short time obviously is a less time
okay.
to understand many so many things.
That's true.
So I'm first time I'm attending. It's very great efforts. I'm looking forward in future also. I'm going to attend it.
Wonderful. Any suggestions for us? Like what kind of formats you are looking for the coming years?
Today I came to know that you are a cartoonist also. So I I want you to take a new theme for cartoonist, at least for speakers from your side.
New thing for cartoonists?
Like theme. You
theme.
Always
okay.
Select one theme for 1 year.
Okay.
So next theme could be cartoons.
Cartoons? Okay, this is interesting.
Yeah.
Okay. Yeah, so from your side, any feedback or anything, what are you looking forward to?
So yesterday's sessions were really interesting.
Uh-huh.
I attended Paul Sherman one and then the one that Mario and Valerie took.
Uh-huh.
I thought they were really interesting. I particularly liked Mario's session because I thought it was really engaging. It was very interactive.
Okay.
I think the level of interaction should be increased a little more.
Okay.
Group activities should be increased a little more because keeps everybody engaged.
Wonderful. This is a good feedback for all
topic.
Our workshop leaders. Yeah. Thank you. And what else actually you are looking forward to?
So
maybe next year or coming years.
It's a good place to get updated on what's happening
mm-hmm.
Outside of the purview of the work that you're currently doing.
Okay.
So I think that should be it. I mean, you should just get to know what others are doing, and I think it's doing that.
Sure, great. So I'll go with one more this side. I'll ask Jaya.
I really enjoyed myself. This is my first time here. I gave
mm-hmm.
some feedback. I was running a workshop. I was terrified because I was coming back and talking
mm-hmm.
to everybody, but I didn't know whether the format would work. You know, we've done this a lot in Europe,
okay.
but we haven't done this here in India.
Uh-huh.
So what are the good things? I think it was very disciplined.
Okay.
Yeah, I mean, in when we do it in Europe, there are fights. So we had about 60, 70 people in the room.
Uh-huh.
There were no fights.
Uh-huh.
Okay? that was amazing. The second thing was that the teams, they came up, they knew the process, you know, they
mm-hmm.
were very, very good. So the client and, was very happy. I mean, there was a client in the room.
Uh-huh.
So that was, because the number of ideas that were generated, the breadth and depth was amazing.
Mm-hmm.
So I'm taking a lot of time. Yeah, so it was really nice. The learning was that, that's what I thought was that sometimes we, couldn't give the instructions completely to the extent that the team wanted. And
okay.
I think some of them came back and said we wanted more time because
oh.
it was a pressure test you know,
okay.
in that sense.
Mm-hmm.
But it's been fantastic. And thank
Wonderful.
You for having me.
Wonderful. Thank you. Anybody wants to give us any, not the feedback, maybe what you guys are looking forward to in the coming years? Because the feedback is really good. So we would like to see if we can alter this format or anything can be introduced, some ideas. Yeah.
Yeah, thanks. Good morning, everyone. One thing I would like to say, there are lots of workshops going parallel and lots of talks and things going parallel.
Yeah.
Maybe some format available to do later online, see it and
yeah.
Preserve it, those data and see it. Because
uh-huh.
as an individual, we cannot have everything in one
room.
So that will
yeah.
be great to have. Something.
Yeah, definitely. Yeah. So this is a very good feedback on the day one also received, and we'd like to record the workshops, at least the talks from next time onwards. And it's always a challenging to attend all four of them at one shot. We have to provide four parallel tracks because the number of people are more. So we also have to make the workshops little so that you get the focused content. So definitely would like to record them. And the talks today and tomorrow, everything will be recorded from zero to the end. The talk will be recorded. But the workshop we haven't done. What we have done is we have taken the glimpses of the workshop, and we asked workshop leader to explain what was it and you know what was the outcome of it and all those things. So that recording will be available. And also the decks. I think there's also a request. Any of the workshop leaders haven't given us the deck. If you have a copyrighted content, remove that or you know mask it, and please give it to us, and we're going to publish that for the benefit of others.
Share the material of other workshops. And
yes.
At least two years.
Sure. Wonderful idea. Yeah, we'll do that. Yeah. Great.
It's also how are we planning to share the current recording?
So we have a YouTube channel. So we're going to send you all the all of you to send. We'll be sending you the links, YouTube channel, and we also have a deck share thing. So we're going to send the link. Yeah. And most importantly, at the end of this conference, I'm going to send you a link, online link. Of course, you are also giving the feedback about the conference, about the speakers. We're going to have another round of feedback, a link, a digital. So we're going to share that. For example, we'll ask you to rate the speakers. So that will be shared with the speakers. So they also get to know where they need to improve. So we're going to announce a goodie for that.
So as you can see, as I mentioned, right, this stage has got a lot of things packed into it. After we are done, Steve is going to come. Steve, it feels like he's all over the conference. So he's going to come and enthrall us again with his interesting presentation, I believe. And after that, it is going to be followed by four panel sessions. So one thing is, after Steve's thing, you're going to split the conference hall into four different streams, four different rooms, as we have been doing for the workshops. These panel sessions are going to be moderated panel sessions, and almost all four of them. The first one is going to be women in design. So this is something that we have started.
We're going to explain that. Before we go ahead, how many of you are coming today new? Like how many of you are new today? We just joined today. Oh, good. Good number. Okay. In fact, today we are going to be more. It looks like people are relaxing and going to come very slow. As I informed, so guys, we are actually celebrating the third day. People who have come to conference today, this is the third day. So we had a day-long workshop on day one, November 1st, and yesterday we had half-day workshops, eight workshops we had. Today, a UX interaction day. We're going to have several talks, like Shyam was talking about, panel discussions, 30-minute talks, 18-minute talks, and we also have sponsor demos, so 15 minutes each. All the top sponsors, they will be doing it. And DesignX presentations. How many of you, anybody from DesignX panelists here? They haven't arrived yet? Okay. We're going to explain about that, what is DesignX. Yeah, let's move on to the next one. So yeah, a track selection. So yesterday evening, people have come and asking that, how about tomorrow, where to select tracks? Today you are free to do whatever you want. You can move around, but once you are in the room, please don't disturb it, don't go out. Generally what happens, a speaker, when somebody's speaking, talking about, presenting, and you are keeping a face and leaving, they might, if they are seasoned speakers, they're fine, otherwise they'll get demotivated. So this session, actually we have different types of speakers. They're all experts and international speakers, also budding speakers, first-time speakers. We wanted to encourage everyone. This is a platform for everyone. So we wanted to give opportunity to everyone. So that's the reason, please encourage them. Okay, and yeah, so you can choose. I'm sure there will be outside a calendar or schedule. You can choose which session you want to attend. And we try to put them sessions in a way that, like in a rooms, one room you try to put it in a technology, another room the process, tools, strategy like that. But some of the presentations we have to adjust, so don't go by rooms. But see the talk description. If you already have you know, website accessed from your mobile, it'll be easy to understand what is the talk. And we also given clearly who are the target people. Is it for experts, or is it for novice, or is it for research? So you can also choose by that way.
Yeah. And when you're there in one room, and while one session is going on, please be there in that room, because it's going to be very difficult to jump between sessions while the session is going on. Once that thing is done, you can feel free to go to other room, but if a live session is going on, one presentation is going on, don't flip rooms. As was mentioned, right, so these four moderated panel sessions are something that we have started 3 years back, and we've been getting great response for women in design. Women in design, as we envisioned, I think this is to celebrate the success of women entrepreneurship and leadership in design. As you can understand, panel sessions are a great way to get wider perspective, I mean expert perspective, from four different people on the panel on an average. So we have three people and four people on these panels today, all experts from the industry. Hoping that it's going to be a great panel session this year too. But the second one is emerging tech and UX. So this is to keep in trend with the changing times, and also to keep in line with the theme of the conference. So we got great folks from industry lined up from various emerging technologies. So please be sure that you are there for that panel too. While I'm saying, I think these things are going in are going to go in parallel. So I think it's a balance that you guys have to strike, right? So
no, actually they're not panel, parallel. That's what I want to tell. So if you want to
parallel, as in while these panels are going on,
correct,
there will be some other talks going on in other rooms.
But that's
true. These sessions,
so if you guys want to attend only these panels, so we try to place it in a way that in one room, for example women in design happens, ends, and the next room, then you're going to attend this emerging tech. So you will not be missing any panel discussions.
Yeah.
But you'll be missing other talks. That's what I think Shyam is talking about.
Yeah. And then we got a design startup. So the main goal for this is to encourage designers to be entrepreneurs and start up based on innovative ideas and things, because we all aspire to be entrepreneurs, right? So I think that's one more thing that this conference is all about. We want to drive that initiative kind of thing. So that's that. And finally, we've got UX Ladder. I think this one got great response last year. This is to help our community to understand from the experience and experienced folks and leaders out there, to understand what it takes for them to grow in their careers.
So this is actually last year we introduced UX Ladder. It was a tremendous response, because what we do is it's an unconference kind of thing, or 30 minutes of unconference. So we just pull people, experienced people, or if you are experienced, you can actually come onto the stage, or you can stand up, and the juniors can ask questions. What should I do to grow in my career, or any kind of questions, and the seniors will help you, answer those queries. So I hope all of the speakers have already submitted your talks. If you haven't done it, I think you should do it by this coffee break. You should do that. And some exceptions. If you are using keynote presentation on Mac, and if it is got interactivity, so most of the presentation systems are PCs, so it may not work on that. So if it is static, you can just create a PDF and give it to us, or you have to disconnect the PC and connect your Mac. So there's a lot of time crunch is there. So only problem is if you're taking a lot of time to set it up, and you have to take that time in your talk, you have to cut down your talk. That's very, very important, because if you push the talk, if you don't end the talk on time, and your fellow speakers are going to suffer, because that goal, it'll go down to the end. So we have to stop for DesignX Awards. So all the talks should be end by the time the DesignX Awards start. Everyone, all the rooms should actually end their talks. So please respect other speakers. Follow the time. If it is 30 minutes, have to close the talk in 30 minutes. Even in the panel discussions, we have to close those panel discussions in 30 minutes. 18-minute talks, exactly 18 minutes. So our volunteers are going to help you, to set the next talk. Immediately they'll disconnect and open the next one. And please respect, and don't shout on them. Okay, if I know that it'll be, you know, you'll get angry because somebody is stopping your presentation. So we are just telling you, you know, heads up that we are going to do that. Please respect, you know, volunteers as well as other speakers. So 30 minutes, yeah. So you can actually, if you want to leave your presentation for 5 minutes, of course we have shared this everything to the speakers, how the format and, you know, even this resolution, everything. So if you want to keep your presentation for question answers, that should be part of your time. So we are just mentioning a 15 minutes talk and 3 minutes questions. You can also say 3 minute talks and 15 minute questions. You can also do that. And similarly, 25 minutes talk and 5 minutes questions. If you don't want to ask any questions, keep it 30 minutes. That's as you wish. So this is another thing. It's very annoying, I know it. It happened to me when I was giving talks. Somebody shows that you have 5 minutes more, 2 minutes more, zero. Then you will be in the halfway, then you have to conclude it. Yes, you have to conclude it. So this comes, you know, as a, like, you know, learning. You know, you should know how to conclude it even if you are in the halfway. Or you have to practice it much better way, like, you know, at least 2-3 times you practice it. Of course, I'm not teaching anything, preaching or to any seasoned or expert speakers. For new speakers are there so many. So make sure that, you know, you are actually being warned 5 minutes, 3 minutes or 0 minutes. When the zero hits, you have to stop your talk. When it is 2 minutes or 3 minutes, they're going to show that you should know that you have to conclude your talk. Wherever you are, you have to close your talk.
All right. So this year, we thought, I think we have been doing this conference for quite some time now, and we have been growing year on year. And one gap that we had, right? So we have been getting a lot of quality content and then very interesting projects from across the board. So that made us think, I mean, we need to reward people as well, I mean, for their work and all those things, and also that would act as a great source of inspiration and encouragement for the newcomers, right? So keeping that in view, we have launched DesignX Awards this year, and then we've received a great response from folks out there. So this afternoon, we are going to look at the shortlisted entries from each category. So we got 5 shortlisted entries per category, that is agencies, enterprises, and startups. So we're going to run 3 sessions this afternoon to go through these shortlisted entries, and then we'll have a jury that will decide the final winners. So we would like to encourage you to attend all of these things, because that's going to be very interesting, because we've been through all the entries, and then we got some quite interesting ideas out there for us to take a look at, right? So that's the highlight of the day.
Yeah, so one important thing is your participation. Why? Because we have 3 awards. One is the jury, like gold and silver. The third one is most popular award. So we are going to give you an SMS number, and then I think you'll see that, right, in television, how do they do it? So you have to, if you like any of the presentations of that category, any of those ideas, you can actually say, for example, we'll actually show you that. We don't have to explain it right now. Your SMS actually helps them to win the most popular award. Okay? So we're going to explain when we are actually at the DesignX Awards here.
And one more thing. I thought that was the only thing, but one more thing that we think is has been a gap as well. I mean, this is something that industry needs for sure, because we don't have any way to benchmark today properly. And again, as I mentioned, this is a platform that is right now at 550 to 600 in terms of attendance. So that's quite a big chunk of designers in India, right? So so we thought that's a good opportunity to get that insight and knowledge from people, and then again share it to the community. So this year we are going to launch Design Quadrant, which is going to benchmark design in India, and then we are going to look at various interesting aspects which will help us progress our careers, right? And progress our discipline, careers, and hopefully I think we will make it a design capital of India kind of thing, right?
So we have a goodies from Sketch. So randomly we select the winners, actually. So one is from Sketch, Nextshare, and Proto.io, 1 year subscription. It's like over $1,000 each. So we're going to win. So if you haven't done it, please take the survey. We're going to close it today because we have a presentation tomorrow, to show you that the analytics, what is right now in India, what's happening in design community. So we're going to have an interesting presentation tomorrow. Yes, we could have done it. Actually, we already sent it several times. Yeah, yeah. Everybody know. I thought, okay, I can do that. Yeah, sure. It's a good idea.
So yeah, stalls. I think we got sponsored setting up stalls. Feel free to go and take a look at the stalls outside. You will get to understand what's going on in there. Right? I mean, this is something that was being done for last couple of years. I think stalls is an interesting way for you to get to know the companies that we have, these red sponsors.
Okay, yeah, so it's a kind of design talent fair kind of thing, because if you see outside today and tomorrow, we're going to have stalls. Slowly the stalls are getting up. I think most of the stalls are already there. Yeah, up there. So we have Adobe, Use Designs, Tiger Spike, also Aetna Health, and we also have different, like Kent University. They're also setting up, and a coffee, Squirrel Coffee is also coming up. And some of the schools, IIT Hyderabad, they also wanted to set up. So this is actually kind of an interesting thing. You guys go to them, talk to them, and they are hiring. They wanted to, you know, get access to the best talent. So this is the right time. You know, all those directly, you know, generally you apply, it goes through several layers and processes, and finally, you meet the final guy. But these guys are, you know, here. You can directly have a discussion with them. You can have a quick dating with them. If it is they like you, maybe they'll ask you to, you know, set up some time, and you guys can actually discuss in the, you know, either near the registration place. You can actually discuss if you really want to join them or discuss it further. So, and also a lot of goodies actually they are offering. We had a workshop yesterday, Dan's and JS. So you have that?
Sure. Can you raise your hands if you were in room number 2 yesterday for first 11 innovation challenge?
Okay, anybody's team 6, right, Gia? Yeah, team 6.
Anybody from team 6?
Only 2, 3? 2 of you? Okay, how many of you guys were in the team? 6? Wow, you lot of money then. Where are the other 4 of, 4 others? Where are the other 4? Yeah, Jay, I think maybe I should give you the mic. So yesterday we announced that, right, they wanted to give away, I don't want to reveal the number right now, for the best ideas and the best team. Yeah.
Is Girish in there? Is Girish around? So Girish was the client from HSBC. He heads up digital. He was in the room. It was very, very interesting. And first, I must apologize for all the mistakes and the learnings that we had. I know that there was one group that was particularly upset with us. So I won't name that group. I'm really, really sorry for you know, the pace at which it was going. But there was another group apart from group 6, right, which did really well, which was group 2. Group 2 did really, really well, right? And to be honest, oh God, where's Girish? My vote went to group 2, but it doesn't mean group 6 wasn't good. But the client loved group 6. And what they loved about group 2 was the innovative way in which they presented the idea, but what group 6 did, they thought was to the brief, would appeal to millennials, and took the brief a step ahead. So congratulations.
Go ahead. Congrats. Please come over. Yeah.
But there are only how many? We've got 8 of them, because we're supposed to be 8.
Give the price.
But they were very. So this has been sponsored by Microsoft and WPP. WPP, as you know, is the world's biggest advertising agency conglomerate. They've been very generous, so we should thank them.
So please, let them come up. Yeah. So, can you also announce what was the cash prize?
What's on the cash prize?
It's 40,000 rupees as Shopper Stop vouchers, because that's, we can't really give cash, but it's 40,000 worth of cash vouchers. Yeah. Shopper Stop.
Would
Would you want to briefly describe your idea? The winning idea.
Sure. All right. So the problem statement from HSBC was that, you know, whenever you apply for a credit card, it takes a very long time to even fill up, and there's a lot of dropouts, and you know, the younger generation will have around 7 seconds to 20 seconds as soon as they see they want to go ahead and do it, and there's a lot of dropouts. So our idea was, you know, to connect them through, you know, social media or any other sites, where our big idea was about a chatbot. And this chatbot was a voice-enabled chatbot. So you go, it will get you all of your information from your social media, like your name, or your address, or whatever you have uploaded. It will take that particular information. And then what it does is, it was gonna go ahead and say, "Hello, Rajiv, how can I help you? Or thank you for choosing HSBC." And this will be on the HSBC site, so it's secure. Plus, what would happen is it will ask you for an Aadhaar number. You just give the Aadhaar number, and by the way, you just need to tell it out, it will type. And once when you get the Aadhaar number, it will get all the information from the Aadhaar and put it onto your form. And it will just gonna go ahead and ask you the other information that you don't have, and you just need to confirm it, and that's it. Cool. And the other one was, 1 minute more. The other one was, you know, it is gonna be a digital card, not a plastic card, right? You can just use it from your mobile and pay. And the credit is gonna get deposited immediately. So in 2 minutes, 3 minutes, you have your credit card plus your amount.
Great, brilliant.
So did you get this award because you had two ideas?
That was the
idea. Yeah.
Thank you so much. Congratulations.
Thank you.
So we have a job board. I think you guys are already familiar with the job board. We have several jobs are being posted. So please go again and check it. I think I've seen today there are more jobs than yesterday. So please don't miss them. Tweet, yesterday also we discussed about this. Like, you know, if you tweet using this hash UXINDIA17 and also use hash UX. So the top three tweeters get these awards, like eggshell prototype, proto, and loop licenses. Thank you, guys.